friend in learning explores The Attack on Pearl Harbor for Kids. Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States was suddenly and deliberately attacked. These words were spoken by Franklin D. Roosevelt, President of the United States of America. Have you heard the word infamy before? The word infamy means criminal or outrageously shameful. Did you know that the United States was attacked in 1941? Did you know that the United States was attacked in the middle of the Pacific Ocean? The Pacific Ocean is huge and the largest ocean in the world. In the center of the Pacific Ocean are a chain of islands, the islands of Hawaii. Of these islands is the island of Oahu, a beautiful island of lush, vertical mountains, dormant volcanoes, and on the south shore, a wide, complex harbor fed by a single inlet. This is Pearl Harbor. It was the perfect place for the U.S. Navy. Plenty of room to park many ships of the Pacific Fleet and an airfield. The Armada would be well protected from an attack from the sea, but maybe not a surprise attack from the air. At that time, Hawaii was not a state, but it was a U.S. territory. Much of the world was at war. Europe was resisting the invasion of Nazi Germany, and Asia was trying to prevent the onslaught from the Empire of Japan. Yes, in 1939, much of the world was at war, but not America. The Americans were just trying to recover from the Great Depression. The Americans did not want to join in any war. Imperial Japan, however, wanted to plant the flag of the rising sun all over China by any means necessary. The nation of Japan needed natural resources, including oil to power their war machine, and the military would do whatever it took to get it. They were belligerent and violent and showed no mercy, as was the Nanking Massacre, for example, when Japanese soldiers raped and murdered between 200,000 to 300,000 Chinese civilians. The attack was brutal and continued for 6 weeks. As a response to this awful Holocaust, the Dutch, Great Britain, and the United States agreed to impose an oil embargo upon Japan, preventing Japan from getting the fuel they desperately needed. The U.S. participated without fully entering the war. This, of course, was unacceptable to the Japanese Empire. In retaliation, their plan was to destroy the Navy of the United States. The naval base at Pearl Harbor must be destroyed. A well-organized and carefully conceived plan was put into motion. Hundreds of aircraft, including dive bombers, fighters, and torpedo planes, loaded on 6 Japanese carriers, along with submarines and midget subs, and other ships made their way to reach striking distance of the naval base at Pearl Harbor and other targets in the South Pacific. It was a Sunday morning, just before 8 a.m. on December 7, 1941. Without warning, a surprise attack by the military forces of the Empire of Japan struck the shipyard at Pearl Harbor. The radio call went out from the Japanese fighter planes. The message was Tora, 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 which meant the U.S. was caught totally by surprise. They hit Hickam Airfield, destroying most of the fighter planes and bombers. The 8 ships on Battleship Row at Ford Island were all hit and either damaged or sunk. The Arizona, the California, the Maryland, the Nevada, the Oklahoma, the Pennsylvania, the Tennessee, and the West Virginia. Many other ships and targets were hit, resulting in severe injuries and loss of precious lives, both military and civilian. This is the USS Arizona Memorial, the only battleship at Pearl not to be repaired and returned to duty. It is a sacred place. Of the 1,177 Marines and sailors killed on this vessel during the attack, 1,102 were never recovered. This is their final resting place. The response of the United States was swift and immediate. The sleeping giant had been wrestled from its sleep. The very next day, President Franklin D. Roosevelt spoke these words, which will never be forgotten.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live and infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan.
Please check out the Clarendon Learning lesson pages on the attack on Pearl Harbor and the video on World War II presented by Clarendon Learning. Thanks for following Clarendon Learning. Be sure to subscribe. For more free resources, check us out at clarendonlearning.org.